Good morning, Lake Church kids. Happy Sunday. Are you ready to find out who the mystery guest is? It's Miss Keeley.
Hey guys, welcome back.
Welcome to part two of our Shake It Up series. Today we're gonna do things a little different and have a dance party, so feel free to join us. Today's story, And did Jesus have a right to get mad? Why or why not? Sometimes standing up for what is right can be easy, but sometimes it can be really difficult. Let's take a look at some of these examples we have. Ms. Keeley has gladly volunteered to help us with this. Okay, so let's take a look at this feather. Imagine this is standing up to someone who just took your best friend's seat at lunch.
I think I can stand up to that easily.
That's good. Now let's try something a little bit more hard. How about a rock? Imagine this is telling your teacher that someone was cheating on a test.
This rock is kind of heavy, but I can still easily stand up to that.
Now let's try something even more hard. How about standing up to a bully?
Oh man, this is kind of a big deal, but I'm still gonna stand up for what's right.
Now this one is really where it's at. How about standing up for God? Let's see.
Oh man, you guys, this one's kind of hard. I can't really move, but with the help of my friends, I can easily stand up for what's right.
That's great. Now let's take a look at the scripture. I want this to be your memory verse for the week.
Okay, the verse is found in 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 13, and it says, "Be on your guard, stand firm in the faith, be courageous, be strong," and continuing with 14, "Do everything in love."
I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Tune in next week to figure out how you can give with a cheerful heart. Let's have a dance party!